Pain Control. So the original, or the first theory on pain control is called the gate control theory. Essentially, it is input along large diameter afferent fibers, also known as A-beta fibers, that can block the transmission of noxious input at the dorsal horn of the spinal cord. This works by blocking the nociceptive pathways in the dorsal horn, which prevents transmission to the sensory centers in the midbrain, which prevents and or reduces the perception of pain. Essentially, that means it's a presynaptic block. An example of this is rubbing your arm after you get hit by, say, a baseball. The next thing we're going to talk about is endogenous opiates. The brain stimulates the pituitary gland and blocks the pain transmission by not allowing depolarization to occur. In the endogenous opiate pain control theory, stimulation of the A-delta or C fibers results in the body's production of endogenous opiates that may produce analgesia by blocking noxious stimuli. The bottom line is that a noxious stimulus through A-delta and C fibers activates this descending pain control mechanism. Lastly, we're going to talk about central biasing. The brain stimulates transmission cells, or T cells, in the dorsal horn and blocks pain transmission by not allowing depolarization to occur. A-delta and C fibers transmit pain impulses up to the thalamus. The thalamus and brainstem send impulses along efferent fibers back to the dorsal horn. These impulses act to inhibit transmission or close the T cell, and this blocks impulses from the first order neurons to the second order neurons. The second order received, but didn't deliver. Nice one. All right, bottom line of this is that stimulation of the descending pathways in the dorsal lateral tract of the spinal cord, because of A-delta and C fibers, afferent impulses already received in higher centers results in a blocking of further impulses carried along spinothalamic tracts. Thank you for your time. Thanks, Bob.